you.
After spending months away from the spotlight, Taylor Swift broke back into the music pop scene in a big way once her first Reputation single, Look at What You Made Me Do, dropped. Not only were the lyrics filled with discernible shade, but the subsequent music video has wrapped up a record-breaking number of views, as fans scour every shot for clues as to what she actually did. Swift packed a lot of Easter eggs into the snake's den for this video, so let's take a look at some of the sneakiest details that made it in. The Walking Dead. If the dress Swift sports in zombie mode early on looks familiar, that's because it's the same one she had on in her Out of the Woods video in 2015, when she was shown crawling through mud for an entirely different reason, heartbreak. There's a common thread beyond the dress and dirt though. Out of the Woods also features her communicating with herself, which is a pretty major element of her new video too. And that wasn't the only familiar in reference contained in the graveyard scene from her new video. If you look closely beside Zombie Taylor, you can also spot a tombstone that belongs to one Neil Schoberg, Swift's pseudonym on the track she co-wrote with ex-boyfriend Calvin Harris called This Is What You Came For. As she later says in the video, the old Taylor is dead, and that evidently includes her efforts to use an alias as well. And the Taylor she buries is sporting some throwback costumery as well, with the same dress and hairstyle she wore to the 2014 Met Gala. The Value of a Dollar. The scene where Swift is bathing in jewels might seem like an obvious dig at Kim Kardashian and the Paris robbery incident that involved a bathroom, a gun, and, you know, jewels. But there was more to it than just mocking Kardashian. For starters, Super Swifties will note that next to the bathtub lies a necklace that looks a lot like the infamous locket Calvin Harris had given her for their one-year anniversary. And the way it's placed, it looks like it's helping to spell out the word no. Considering she's later shown standing next to an empty ring box, and Harris was reportedly shopping for engagement rings before they broke up, some fans think she might have turned down the chance to marry him. Also hidden among the bath of flashy jewelry is a lone dollar bill that's meant to signify more than just money. Swift was recently awarded a single buck in her countersuit against a DJ who allegedly groped her during a press event in 2013, and then sued her for defamation after he was fired for the incident. Given its placement among an estimated $10 million worth of diamonds, Swift's seemingly indicating that this dollar was worth so much more to her than its face value. Snakes everywhere. Throughout the video for Look What You Made Me Do, snakes can be spotted in several scenes, and one even serves a tea, which is a modern colloquialism for gossip. Her inclusion of the animal is a clear callback to the moment her feud with Kanye West added a third party when Kim Kardashian celebrated National Snake Day by releasing an audio recording of Swift and West discussing his lyrics to Famous, a song which she'd later take issue with for mocking her. She also snuck in a few further jabs of the Kardashian-West brood, with her gaudy fashions and slicked hairstyle. And she directly referenced the feud by implying the Kardashian leak was doctored before parodying her own effort to remove herself from the feud once and for all, saying at the end of the video, "I would very much like to be excluded from this narrative." Biting Beyoncé? Before the full video was even released, Swift was accused of biting Beyoncé's formation routine, but it may have been another video that inspired Swift's dance sequence. Some of her dance moves seem to be emulating what Beyoncé did in her Single Ladies video, which just so happens to be the same one she beat at the 2009 VMAs, which started the whole debacle with Kanye West in the first place, and the fact that she slings around a bat, like Beyoncé so famously did in her Lemonade visual album. Well, it doesn't seem like a coincidence. Waxing Shakespeare. A casual viewer might take one glance at the Et tu Brute line inscribed on Swift's golden throne and assume that she was a big Shakespeare nerd in high school, but this probably has more to do with Katy Perry than the bard. Swift and Perry had a long-standing feud as well, and since Perry once referred to her as a Regina George in sheep's clothing, Swift may be calling back to that moment in Mean Girls when Gretchen Wiener talked about killing Julius Caesar.
"And when did it become okay for one person to be the boss of everybody, huh? Because that's not what Rome is about! We should totally just stab Caesar!"
And while some suspect the car crash scene might be a piece of shade for Kanye West's career-defining accident from 2002 that conspiracy theorists think he faked, that part might have been meant for Perry too. Consider the shot of her showcasing a Grammy, which Perry has never won, and the jealous cat leering in the passenger seat. Not only is the outfit something Perry would definitely wear, but Swift's golden sports car and shades also look a lot like what Perry sported in her Waking Up in Vegas video. Blind for Love. Swift didn't just take on other celebrities in the video. She's also railed against the common perception that she's a love-hungry sap who bounces from guy to guy. This is why she's seen wearing a sequined sweatshirt that bears the phrase blind for love, and has eight men, which symbolizes the number of high-profile relationships she's had. All wearing the iHeartTS shirt her latest ex, Tom Hiddleston, was photographed in. As a bonus, check out the Apple One dancer tosses into the air during the beginning of the dance scene. Doesn't it remind you of Swift's Apple prop in Blank Space? As if that weren't enough, Swift even seems to be making a conscious statement in a choice of robbery mask. All those cat masks appear to be a nod to her frequent title of Cat Lady. Even Swift's own mask looks like her Scottish fold, Olivia Benson. Cultural commentary. Beyond her specific digs, Swift also managed to bring in a bit of commentary against the digital streaming industry, which she's openly feuded with over their royalty policies. In the robbery sequence, the backdrop sign reads Stream Co., which is an obvious reference to Swift's refusal to allow her music to be played on several services and the subsequent accusations of greed lodged against her. And she also snapped back at the industry at large by showing herself locked in a birdcage, with a lobster dinner that may refer to her repeatedly being followed by photographers, especially around her estate in Cape Cod. Most obviously, she bit back on the common claims that she was trying to lead a crew of carbon copy women with a squad summit wherein the characters wore Bad Blood-esque costumes and seemed to die off and leave her stranded solo. 15 Taylors, 15 Tracks. Towards the end of the music video, Swift stands on a mountain of her former selves, all wearing iconic outfits from the past. One of those Taylors is none other than You Belong With Me Taylor. While the Look What You Made Me Do version of the shirt looks strikingly similar, there's one notable difference. The name signed on the shirt. Look closely and viewers can see that Swift's included all the members of her squad on her shirt, including pals Selena Gomez, Lena Dunham, Martha Hunt, and Blake Lively and Ryan Reynolds. And at the tail end of Swift's video, she's lined up 15 versions of herself to sling around some of the common insults that have been hurled at her over the years. The number 15 is significant because that's how many tracks will appear on her new album. Could the specific Taylors included here be a primer for what each song will be about? We'll just have to wait until the album's release on November 10th, 2017 to find out. Thanks for watching. Click the Nicki Swift icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too.